Hey guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today we are going to check out the Wildwood. This is called the 27DBK, double bunk outside kitchen. The cool thing about this floor plan is it has some good sized bunks. They're not little skinny ones, they're a little bit wider, and the bottom bunks actually flip up to put a nice chest or bikes or you name it. So that's a really cool feature, and the outside kitchen. So instead of having to grill inside in that hot camper, you can make it so that your camper doesn't smell like grilled steaks or bacon or whatever for the next two camping trips. All that can be done out here. And I am excited to show you that. We're gonna show you some of the outside features and the inside features. Unfortunately, this one was in our hailstorm that came through, so our loss is your gain. So I'm excited to say there is a drastic save thousands type of situation. Click on the link to find out what our price is, because it's extremely low, lower of course than it's ever been because of the hail damage. So if you can live with a couple cosmetic things on the side and the front, then this coach might be for you. Let's show it to you. Starting off, this weighs 6534. That's the dry weight of this coach. That doesn't include all the options that we would put in this coach. This also has two 20-pound propane tanks. It has a cover big enough to put two 30-pound tanks if you need to. This also has a power front tongue jack, so you can easily see what you're doing in the middle of the night if you're connecting or unhooking. You can see that with the light, as well as being able to not have to crank it up and down with some elbow grease. Over here, since this is the standard Wildwood, this is going to have pass-through storage, but it's also going to have a bigger door on the other side. So if this door isn't quite as big as you'd like, come on over here. You'll notice this one's a lot larger, and you can access all this stuff from inside the master bedroom as well. Solar port right here, power tongue, or power stabilizer jacks, I should say, power awning, outside speakers, and the outside kitchen. I want to show you a couple things. One, look at these stairs. This is a triple stair that's called the solid step, so it's not gonna rock on you like a normal set of camper stairs would. And then the other thing I wanted to grab was this remote. So I'm gonna grab that remote right now. This thing right here will allow you to put your awning out, put your stabilizer jacks down, put your slide out, turn on the awning light. Let's see if I can select the right deal on here. And it's going through. All right, and I'm gonna select, how about the awning? So if I wanna put the awning out, I can do that. If I wanna turn on these lights, I can do that with the push of a button. If there's a big tree right next to you, you can see that tree and put out your awning at the same time. If it's raining outside, you could put your stabilizer jacks down, your awning out before you even step outside your car. So really cool feature right there. And then another awesome thing is this outside kitchen. So if I hook this right here, you have sink, storage, refrigerator, grill. This one swings around right here so that you can have the whole setup going on without having to go inside the coach. You also have a spot for a backup camera if you decide to add a backup camera. We sell those in our parts store. And although this is not an enclosed underbelly, these tanks are actually heated with heat pads directly on the tanks themselves. The cool thing about that is it's rated down to negative 11 degrees. So that is a great thing if you're gonna go a little bit later in the season. All right, come on inside. And these are the giant bunk beds that I was telling you about. So this is cool. And I'll go ahead and close this so our camera looks right. But yeah, if you have some kind of bikes or ice chest, whatever you have, that can fit there. And then this can go back down. And then your kids can actually grow into these beds and not feel all cramped. So super nice feature. Also, this has one of the best pantries that you'll see. So look how deep that pantry is. And then this has also got one of the best layouts for a bunk model, because you'll notice the couch and dinette are right across from where you would put a TV. So again, you're not cranking your neck a weird way to be able to watch your movie together as a family. This is a spot to put like all your shoes so they're not piled up right underneath, right at the door. As we can kind of move into the kitchen here, you can see that you have a gas electric refrigerator, so this can run off both propane or plugged into a campsite. Pull down sink faucet, solid surface countertop, oven, 3-burner stove, microwave, surround sound built in. This also has ducted air conditioning, so you can cool down the unit a lot more evenly. As you can see, we have a lot of cabinetry to work with, and then they even extend this countertop out. Over here, this does also turn into a bed. You can fit 2 full-size adults on this very easily. And then these are pull-out drawers. So see how long that pulls out to. And then you can also access all the storage underneath here by pulling up the pillows. These have the extra large windows. And then these are openable. So if you want to get, ooh, that feels nice actually. Move some air through here, you can do that. And then they didn't skimp when they did the side windows either. They have side windows. The couch also folds into a bed. It's more of like a jackknife style couch. And this would be more for like little kids or something like that. But the cool thing about this couch is it does have a giant storage area underneath it. So pillows, blankets, linens, you name it. And these are all push button LED lights as well. And then you can see this is kind of lit up too for some nice ambiance. Moving over into the master bedroom, again, they did not skimp. They went with a nicer Denver mattress as opposed to a entry-level mattress. You also have storage on both sides for some hanging storage, and then 2 windows for cross ventilation, and this is an emergency exit window so that you can escape in a hurry if you need to. And then there is a TV hookup here, so if you decide to add a bedroom TV, no problem. And last but not least, we do have a larger bathroom. So this is big enough to do like a changing room as opposed to just a bathroom, which is kind of nice if you have kids, you know, and you need to switch into your trunks or whatever, no big deal. Medicine cabinet in the corner here. And then this is a tub. So if you have little kids, you can give them a bath. But also if you're an adult, you have a little bit more headroom with a skylight for some extra natural light. So if you like the video, please hit the like button. That really helps me out. Also subscribe, as we always have tons of videos to show you, and we'd love to let you know about all the new products and features that are coming out. Yeah, if you have any questions, feel free to reach us at thegreatoutdoorsrv.com. If you like this, but it's maybe a little too big, you should check out the WILDWOOD 282 QBXL or the 273 QBXL, or if you wanted to go smaller even yet, you could check out the WILDWOOD FSX series, and you could go all the way down to like a 230 BHXL, which is even smaller. So yeah, our phone number, 970-313-4337, and if you need help with financing, we can do that. Trade-ins are welcome. Let us know what you need. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.